Hello, I'm Blayne Reed. I'm the APM agent for Hell, Swisher, and Floyd County with Texas A&M AgriLife Extension. And today we're in a sorghum field down at the experiment station in Lubbock. And we're going to talk about a lot of the head pests in sorghum, those that can be robbing that grain yield. We're going to be talking headworms, which consist of corn earworm or bollworm, whatever you want to call him, or headworm, of course, and fall armyworms, Lygus potentially, and potentially stink bugs as well. Anything that can rob that pest, we'll see if we can scout for them and keep you out of trouble. So when we're out scouting the field in West Texas, sorghum, I like to use beet buckets when we're looking for all of these head damaging pests. My preferred beet bucket is simply a milk carton. I've cut the bottom out, I've left a little bit of lip on. I can get the head in here, shake things around. This allows light to go through inside of here so I can see what pest I'm dealing with and what's shaking loose out of the head, and I can identify my pest. I like to get several per field in the neighborhood of 20 to 30, maybe upwards of 50, depending on field size. But to do this, we simply put the head in, shake it around, identify what comes out, and we actually do have a fall armyworm inside of this one. Now, we don't have to use just a milk carton. For larger heads, better yields, you can use a larger beet bucket, trash can, 5-gallon bucket. The principle remains the same, is get it in there, shake it loose, and see what comes out, get it identified. So the type of insects we'll be shaking loose in these fields that we're checking for are going to be the bollworm and the fall armyworm, which together are both considered headworms, but we need to identify between these two, because what will kill a bollworm is not likely to kill a fall armyworm. So we need the type of product, if you have fall armyworms in the field, that will control both pests. So the difference between a bollworm or corn earworm, if you prefer to call it, and a fall armyworm, the fall armyworm's Y on its head will be much more distinctive than the bollworm will be, and they will have a very distinctive spot pattern on the tip of the abdomen. Now when we shake loose, we'll also have some true plant bugs that are going to be coming loose. We can have some Lygus or stink bugs. Both of these pests will take their piercing sucking mouth parts and will pull weight out of the grain. They tend to like the grain after it starts getting some color to it, going into that hard dough stage. But we think if they attack earlier in the year, they could be an issue. Lygus are going to have a very distinctive triangle in their back. The nymphs, we'll see quite a few of those. They'll have spots in their back. And of course, we've got the stink bugs, several species of stink bugs here in West Texas that could do similar damage. The threshold for those should be several, possibly 10 or so or a dozen or so per head.